This is Eric, the Cocos Evangelist. Since the release of Cocos Creator 3.0, more and more developers have been experimenting with 3.0. I also recommend my friends to use it, and they've started to try Cocos Creator to develop games. But some of them may find it hard to start. This time, I'll use a very detailed tutorial, Mind Your Step, as an example, to introduce you to the whole development process using Cocos Creator. In the last video, I introduced how to get Cocos Creator and also introduced the basic panels. In this video, I'll show you how to get resources to build a game scene. There are many ways to get resources. You can get resources from the art designers in your company, or you can search online. You can also get resources from Cocos Store. You can find it in extension store. There are many resources here, including code resources, art resources, etc. We choose art. Oops, no content. The current language is English. There are not many resources in English version, so we can switch the language to Chinese. Then open the store again. Choose art resources. Maybe you can find something you need here. Cocos has also compiled a list of most of its own free resources for you to use. The resources used in this game include the sky model provided by Hello3D World, Cocos astronaut models, and cloud models provided by external model sites. First, get the sky model. Click Free, Get. Click Install. Choose the assets directory. However, the assets panel is not updated. Open the assets folder. You can see that the resource pack we've just installed is actually in this folder, but it's a zip file, which needs to be unzipped. Since the current version of Cocos Creator doesn't support auto-unzipping yet, we need to unzip it manually. But the later versions will support auto-unzipping. Open the pack. As you can see, it's not just a resource pack. It's the entire project. We need to extract resources from the project. Just wanted to show you how to get resource packs from Cocos Store. Okay, delete the resource pack and replace it with the resources I've prepared. These resources include Sky Model from the Hello3D World pack, as well as Cocos Model and Cloud Model from external model sites. Select the three folders and drag them into the assets directory. Now we have three model resources. Next, we can start building the game scene. First, build the game environment. Select the Sky Model. Drag it into the hierarchy panel. Scroll the mouse wheel to adjust the field of view. Double-click on the model node to quickly locate the model. Notice that the sky model is yellow. That's because when the artist exports the model in the modeling software, the texture asset path associated with the model is an absolute path. If you share the absolute path with others, the asset on that path won't be found. Then the texture association will fail. In this case, choose the model asset. Check Material, Dump Materials in the Inspector panel. This way, its material is exported. Select the exported material. The texture associated with it is wrong. Select the right texture and drag it into this property. Apply. Then replace the model's material with the correct one. Okay, now the sky model looks normal. So, what is the material? You can think of it as the appearance of an object, which can interact with light. For example, a pipe. Is it made up with plastic or metal? And whether the metallic texture has a wear effect. These are all implemented by materials. So how are the materials used for the nodes? Since the material determines the appearance of the model, rendering is involved. Search for nodes with rendering components on all nodes of the model. The rendering component used for the model is the mesh renderer. Just place the corresponding material property of the mesh renderer. Next, Edit the character and the cloud. Double-click to locate. This is the character. It's magenta, which means its materials are lost. Not a single one. Similarly, select the character, material, dump materials. But there is no material exported. Restore it. Look at this resource pack, which has some issues. It has no materials in itself. In this case, we have to create a material called Cocos. Select the material. Attach the texture on it. Select Use Albedo Map. This one, base color, which is the basic texture. Attach it on the character. You can see that the model has four slots. When I drag the texture into one of the slots, only a part of the model is rendered correctly. As I drag the texture into the rest of the slots, the whole model will be rendered. Now you can see the whole astronaut model. This part of the operations are actually due to my fault, which made it more difficult to use the model. I'll update the resource pack later. In the new resource pack, you'll see a file called Cocos with an icon like this. Just drag the file into the scene to use. Those complex operations are no longer needed. Then what kind of asset is it? It's actually a prefab. Prefab is the description file of a game object. It stores a game object, all its component properties and child game objects as a whole in the assets folder for multiple use. Prefabs are used as templates, which allows you to create new prefab instance directly in the scene. So I can just make a prefab of the parts of the model that are fragmented or to be fixed. And of course, the previous contingency solution of losing model materials can also be one of the solutions for similar problems encountered later. Next, drag the cloud into the scene. Well, it's too big. We can scale it. Then you can make further adjustments to it. You can use three keys on your keyboard, W, E, and R. W is the move gizmo. E is the rotate gizmo. And R is the scale gizmo. We can use the scale gizmo to adjust the size of the cloud. But how can we be sure it's already the right size we want since we can't see the back of the cloud? There are some ways to adjust the point of view. One is holding down the right mouse button to rotate the point of view. At the same time, press and hold the scroll wheel to pan the view, so that we can rotate and pan the view at the same time. Another way is holding down the right mouse button. Then you can see WASD appears at the bottom left of the scene panel, which allows you to move the point of view with your keyboard. This, combined with rotation, allows us to observe the model in all directions. If you want to quickly locate a certain view, you can use the gizmo in the top left corner. This gizmo corresponds exactly to the coordinate system, so if you want to look at the front side of the model, click the Z-axis of the gizmo. The point of view will immediately jump to the direction facing the Z-axis of the model. If you want to look at the top of the model, just click the green arrow. Now we can see the top of the model. So we can quickly locate any of the faces perpendicular to the axis by using the gizmo. All of the above are ways to make it easier to adjust our viewing angle. Also, there's a menu at the top right of the scene panel. which allows you to make some adjustments to the camera, like the FOV, the near plane and the far plane. The wheel speed is the speed at which the camera moves when moved with the mouse wheel. The wander speed is the speed at which the camera moves in different directions when we press the right mouse button and manipulate it with the W, A, S, and D keys. Save the scene. You better save scenes often when making games to avoid data loss when some errors occurs in the editor. That's all for today. See you in the next video.